हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द मैक बॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न हाउ टू डिजाइन अ शाफ्ट सब्जेक्टेड टू ओनली ट्विस्टिंग मोमेंट। वी नो दैट द इक्वेशन ऑफ टॉर्सन दैट इज टाउ बाय आर इज इक्वल टू टी बाय जे इज इक्वल टू सी थीटा बाय एल। नाउ हियर टाउ इज शियर स्ट्रेस, आर इज द रेडियस ऑफ शाफ्ट, or you can say that distance of the extreme layer from neutral axis. But in our case, if we are having a circular shaft, then R will be radius. Capital T is the torque or twisting moment. Capital J is polar moment of inertia. And C, now here C is modulus of rigidity, theta is angle of twist, and L is length of the shaft. From the equation of torsion, we will use only first two terms, that is tau by R is equal to T by J. With the use of this equation, we have to design a solid shaft and a hollow shaft. So first, let us consider one solid shaft having circular cross-sectional area with diameter D. Now here, in this equation, this R is the distance of extreme layer from neutral axis. So suppose this is our neutral axis, so distance of the extreme layer will be radius R. So R is equal to diameter by 2. And J is polar moment of inertia for any circular section. J will be equal to pi by 32 into D raised to 4. Now let us put these values in this equation. So tau by R, R is D by 2, is equal to capital T by J. J is pi by 32 into D raised to 4. By simplifying this equation, we will get capital T torque is equal to pi by 16 into tau into D cube. Here tau is the permissible stress. So for any case or any case study for a shaft, capital T and tau will be given in data and we can find out diameter D for a solid shaft. Now let us derive the equation for a hollow shaft. Consider the cross-sectional area of a hollow shaft with outer diameter DO and internal diameter as DI. Now here distance of the extreme layer from neutral axis, it will be outer radius. Outer radius will be DO by 2. So R is equal to DO by 2. Now for this cross-sectional area, polar moment of inertia J is equal to pi by 32. Into outer diameter raised to 4 minus inner diameter raised to 4. Now we have to put these two values in the equation of torsion. So tau by R, R is DO by 2 is equal to capital T by J, J is pi by 32 into DO raised to 4 minus DI raised to 4. By simplifying this equation, we will get capital T is equal to pi by 16 into tau into bracket DO raised to 4 minus DI raised to 4 by DO. Here capital T is the torque and tau is permissible shear stress. For any particular case or any numerical, the basic relation between outer diameter and inner diameter of a hollow shaft will be given. So you can replace any of these two values and find out the other diameter. In many numericals and in many cases, you will find out that the torque is not given and instead of that, power and RPM is given. So in that case, if we want to find out the torque applicable on shaft, we have to use this equation P is equal to 2 pi NT by 60. Now here, P will be in terms of volt, N will be in terms of RPM, then you will get torque in terms of Newton meter. You have to remember this thing that if torque is in terms of Newton and meter and N is in terms of RPM, then power will be in terms of volt. Now let us solve one numerical related to design of shaft subjected to only twisting moment. Now in this numerical, a line shaft rotating at 200 RPM is to transmit 20 kilowatt. So RPM and power is given, N is 200 RPM and power is 20 kilowatt. In terms of watt, 20 into 10 raised to 3. The shaft may be assumed to be made of mild steel with allowable or permissible shear stress is 42 MPa. So tau is given, 42 MPa means 42 Newton per mm square. And we have to determine the diameter of shaft if bending moment is neglected. It means in this data or in this numerical, we do not have to consider bending moment. So to find out the diameter of shaft, we are having this equation for solid shaft, capital T is equal to pi by 16 into tau into dq. Now in this data, torque is not given, but instead of torque, power and RPM is given. So first we have to find out torque with the use of this equation. P is equal to 2 pi nt by 60. Power will be 20 into 10 raised to 3 is equal to 2 pi as it is. RPM is 200, torque as it is by 60. By solving this equation, we will get torque is equal to 955 Newton into meter. But we have to convert this Newton meter into Newton mm. So 955 into 10 raised to 3 Newton into mm. So in next step, we will put the value of torque in equation number 1. That is 955 into 10 raised to 3 is equal to pi by 16 as it is into 42 Newton per mm square, that is our permissible shear stress, into dq. By solving this, we will get D is equal to 48.7 mm, and as per the standard size, the nearest size will be 50 mm. That will be our final answer. Let us solve another numerical. Now in this numerical, we have to find the diameter of a solid steel shaft to transmit 20 kilowatt power at 200 rpm. The ultimate shear stress of the steel may be taken as 360 MPa and a factor of safety as 8. So first we have to write down given data, that is power 20 kilowatt. So we have to convert in terms of watt, 20 into 10 raised to 3. N is given, 200 rpm. Now here ultimate shear stress is given, tau u is equal to 360 MPa. And factor of safety is also given as 8. In next step, if a hollow shaft is to be used in place of the solid shaft, it means we are replacing a solid shaft by a hollow shaft for same amount of power. Find the inside and outside diameter when di by do is 0.5. So first we have to find out the design stress or permissible stress from this ultimate stress with the use of factor of safety. So to find the permissible shear stress, we have to divide ultimate shear stress by factor of safety, 360 by 8. So we will get 45 Newton per mm square as our permissible shear stress. Now next, here power and N is given, so we have to find out torque with this equation. Power is 20 into 10 raised to 3 is equal to 2 pi as it is into RPM is given 200 into torque T by 60. By solving this equation, we will get torque is equal to 955 into 10 raised to 3 Newton into mm. For this particular value of torque, we have to find out diameter of a solid shaft and diameters of hollow shaft. So to find out the diameter of a solid shaft, we are having the equation T is equal to pi by 16 into tau into dq. Torque is 955 into 10 to the power 3 is equal to pi by 16 into 45 is our permissible shear stress into dq. By solving this equation, we will get D is equal to 47.6, but as per the standard size, our final answer will be 50 mm. Now on the other hand, if we want to find out the diameters of the hollow shaft, then we are having the equation T is equal to pi by 16 into tau into dO raised to 4 minus dI raised to 4 by dO. Now in this equation, we will modify this equation because ratio of dI by dO is given in data. So if we put the values here, torque is 955 into 10 to the power 3 is equal to pi by 16 as it is. Permissible shear stress is 45 into dO cube into bracket 1 minus here dI by dO, it is given in data as 0.5 raised to 4. By solving this equation, we will get the value of outer diameter as 48.6 mm. But as per the standard size, it will be 50 mm. And from the ratio, we can find out inner diameter dI as 0.5 times of dO, so it will be 25 mm. Hope you enjoyed this video. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you.